Hello students, very nice morning to all of you. Myself Deepak Kumar Pusti from Modern English School, Indinagar, Nevada, France. Students, very welcome to our e-learning class of fourth video lecture of the class 6. So student, today I am going to discuss memory. In the last, we have already discussed input device, output device, processing device, some of the storage device also. And today is the last topic of the first chapter, that is your memory. The student, as we know that memory is used to store the information in the computer for the permanent and for the later. That means, first of all, we are using the internal memory. Then after that, what we need to store the information, a very large amount of information stored inside the computer, we use external memory. So memory can be divided into two types. That is, one is the internal memory, another one is the external memory. The internal memory are of the RAM or ROM, and external memory are the very large memory for which we can store the very large amount of data for the memory. Is that clear? A student, the memory. In the memory are of two types, primary memory and secondary memory. And today class, we will discuss only the primary memory. First one, this one is your primary memory. Then second one, secondary memory. Secondary memory. The student, the memory, where you store the data in the computer, it will be processing in the form of 0 and 1. Is that clear? In processing of data inside the computer, store the data in the computer in the form of 0 and 1 bits. That is called 0 and 1. Store the data in the computer in the form of 0 and 1 bits. That is called as a, that is called as a binary. That is called as a binary. So basically the memory can be divided into two types. One is a primary memory, one is a secondary memory. And according to the syllabus of your book, we will discuss only the primary memory. So primary memory is again divided into two types. Primary memory is again divided into two types. What are the? One is your volatile memory. One is volatile memory. Another one is non-volatile memory. So what do we mean by volatile and what do we mean by non-volatile? The student, volatile memory means the data cannot be stored permanently. Means at the time of running of your computer, so you can read the data or you can write the data from the computer. And in case of the non-volatile memory, the data can be stored permanently. And in case of the non-volatile memory, you can only read the data, but cannot be write the data. Is that clear? So volatile memory is a RAM. And non-volatile example is a ROM. So RAM is a random access memory. ROM is a read only memory. So RAM is called as a volatile memory because the data can be lost when the power is switched off from the computer system. But in case of the ROM, the data can be stored permanently when your power will be switched off from the computer. Once power will be switched switched up, still the data can be saved in the RAM. That's why this is called the non-volatile memory. But in case of volatile memory, at the time of running of the computer, the data is saved. When computer is switched off, they can be lost. That's why this is called as a volatile memory. So, random access memory and read-only memory. So, student, now we discuss the next primary memory or internal memory also you can tell. Next internal memory of the computer system is the cache memory. One is the cache memory. One is also very important role of the computer system. Cache memory. So cache memory is also one of the internal memory. It is a very small and its accessing speed is very fast. So that's why the cache memory is very small memory and very fast memory. For these helping or it is used to reduce the average time to access the data from the main memory. It helps to the our RAM because by the use of cache memory it reduce the average time cost while access the data from the main memory. Is that clear or not, student? So that's why we are using the cache memory, and it's very small. And the cache memory is very closer to the processor as compared to the primary memory, the main memory of the computer system. Is that clear or not? The cache memory is very closer to the processor. The student. So what we have discussed, primary memory and secondary memory, RAM and ROM. Is that clear or not? That means the primary memory from the RAM also, it is but while we access the data, so it will be closer with the central processing unit. Means when we access the data by the help of the processor. That means the volatile memory or non-volatile memory, both are directly access to the CPU, but the external memory cannot directly access with the CPU. Remember this one. The primary memory is directly access with the CPU, but the secondary memory is not directly access with the CPU. So student, in this way we have discussed. Now come to the how the cache memory is working. You see this diagram. CPU, then cache, then RAM. So we have already discussed what is the use of cache memory. Then what is the use of RAM? It is used to both read into or write from the computer system. Is that clear or not? So student, now come to the CPU, cache and RAM. First, here I have written first in cache for the data. So when the data will be in the cache memory, then what will happen? If the data is in cache memory, then it send it to CPU and store. That means when the data will be in the cache memory, when the data are in the cache memory, directly it will send from cache memory to the CPU and store. Is that clear or not? The next third one you see, if the data is not in cache, the data are not available in the cache memory, then what will happen? The CPU will send the data to the primary memory, that is your RAM. Then if the data is not in cache, then what will happen? The data can be fetched from the RAM. That means to access the data from the RAM. If the data is not available in cache, then what will happen? The data can be fetched or accessed from the RAM. Then what will happen? Send data from RAM, then write into the cache memory. After fetching the data, then CPU is fetching from the RAM. Then what will happen? The RAM will send the data to the cache memory. Then what will happen? Here it will Here it will be written. After that, send to the speed. So in this way, the cache memory is working. If the data is in cache memory, then directly send to the CPU, it will stop. If the data is not in cache, then it will fetch the data from the first of all RAM. Then RAM will send to the cache. It will write there. Then it will send that to the CPU. So in this way, the cache memory is working. Is that clear? Next one to the student, memory representation. How to represent the memory in a computer system? Memory representation. Memory representation. Memory representation. That means student, when you store the data in the computer, there are different size of the data can be stored in the computer memory. So we discussed that one. So there are different types of the memory representation. The student, the first one is about the data can be represented in a memory. First of all, 0 and 1 bit format. That is called as a binary bit. Is that clear? Then that means first one is about bit format. That one is about 0 and 1. Is that clear, student? The next one is student, nibble. That is about 4 bits. Combination of the 4 bits, that one is about 1 nibble. Then word. Then word is about the fixed size of the combination of a group of bits. Fixed size of combination of group of some of the bits. That one is a what? What? That means we can get 8, then 16, then 32, then 48, like this. So in this way we can represent the what? Then the combination of the fixed size of the bits. Then students come to the word. In the byte, it is very too less, very too less, very small memory represent of the computer system. So that's why we are preferring kilobyte, megabyte. Is that clear or not, student? So student, so the byte is very too small to represent the data in a computer system. So that's why we are using the word kilobyte, megabyte, then gigabyte, then terabyte, then petabyte. Is that clear or not, student? Then exabyte. Is that clear? Then yottabyte, then zettabyte. So in this way, there are different types of the memory unit of the computer system. So student, remember, 1 kilobyte is your 1024 bytes. Okay? 1 megabyte, 1024 kilobyte. Then 1 gigabyte, 1024 megabyte. Then 1 terabyte, 1024 gigabyte. So like this, you can represent different unit of the computer system. The student, the memory part is very important part in our computer system, both internal and external memory. Okay? And today class we have discussed what will be volatile memory, what will be non-volatile memory, different unit of the computer system and cache memory. That's it.